Don't believe me, just Yeah. trying to eat, homie, cause the bar. I said, please, por favor. Let me in a beach, y'all. Vente, vente. I grind hard on my head, thing. What did they promise? They paint, thing. Damn. Con César Roja y Verde. Taco Tuesday, my favorite day. That's the reason why I'm on the way. Pero I don't care, homie, let them hate. I'm just trying to eat. Another play.
Another one.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro tacos. Don't forget the rice and beans on the plato. I like to eat, homie, yo no estoy flaco. Yeah, I'm chubby, but I'm still guapo. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro tacos. Don't forget the rice and beans on the plato. I like to eat, homie, yo no estoy flaco. Yeah, I'm chubby, but I'm still guapo.
Girl, girl, 말해줘 니 마음 바로 지금. Baby, 같이 올라가자.
Este amor tan inmenso que nos
quiero tanto más que el cielo, lágrimas de dolor. He tocado fondo tantas veces luchando por tu amor. Soy incondicional, un amor tan real, que no juzga, que sueña, que sufre y perdona, un amor de verdad. Soy incondicional, un amor tan real, que no espera algo a cambio, que no tiene horario, un amor de verdad.
And today we're going to be interviewing Madlox. So, hey Madlox, can you tell us what it feels to live in a box?
I got some friends in there. I got my friend Angelica. We hang out a lot. We go on dates because I kind of catch feelings for her, you know? Can you explain why your color is red? Is it just red?
I think it's because I eat a lot of chili peppers, but sometimes I'm very, very mad.
And I'm your news reporter, Edgar, and thanks for watching the news.
What's so special about you? It was all about me before you came along. You took away everything from me. Everything. I had all of it before you. Now you come along and just take my life. Mom and Dad used to like me. They didn't even want you.
What brings you here, boys, to my office?
I looked up and my gel pudding was gone. And I know he took...
Journey, look at me.
Nigga.
Look at that smile. That's pudding face. You took my pudding.
The evidence is hard to dispute.
Nick.
You look very sorry. I'm gonna let this go.
What? That's unfair.
Mr. Toho, how many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Roll lollipop?
Well, I don't know. You should ask Mr. Owl. I always end up finding.
Mr. Owl, how many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Roll lollipop?
Good question. Let's find out. One, two, three.
There's anything I can't stand, and that is a smart owl. How many licks does it take to get to the center of the seal lollipop?
The world may never know.
Look, Simba, everything the light touches, our kingdom. A king's time is ruled, rises and falls like the sun. One day, Simba, the sun will set up my time here and will rise with you as the new king. And this will be my everything.
Minions, so assemble. Okay, looking good, Kevin. How is the family? Good? What up, Larry? Hello, everybody. Yeah, all right. Simmer down. Thank you. Okay, now I realize you guys probably heard about this other villain who stole the pyramids. Apparently, it's a big deal. People are calling it the crime of the century and stuff like that. But am I upset? No, I'm not. Not a little. But we have had a pretty good year ourselves. We stole the Statue of Liberty, the small one, from Las Vegas. Next, we're gonna steal the moon.
Curiosity often leads to trouble. Oh, goodbye, Dinah. Goodbye. After this, I shall think nothing of falling downstairs, people walking upside down. Oh, but that's silly. Nobody. Almost arriving. Wait, please.
Thank you. to be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so much. Goodbye to Matt. Oh, don't cry. You rest so dreadfully.
Now I know. I have a heart. It's breaking.
Goodbye, Lion. I know it isn't right, but I'm going to miss the way you used to holler for help before you found your courage.
I would never have found it if it wouldn't have been for you.
And Scarecrow, I think I'll miss you most of all.
Goodbye, dear friend. Are you ready now?
Yes, I am ready. Say goodbye, Toto.
Now close your eyes and think to yourself. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Keen. Jayla. Danae.
Anaya.
Well, this energy ball. I must sell it to Valerie.
Please, Your Majesty, I wish to be paid today.
What have you done to deserve to be paid?
I have decorated your castle inside from out with Christmas decorations.
Ah, thank you. I appreciate that. Here is your pay.
Please, Your Majesty, Your Kingdoms, I wish to be paid today.
What have you done to deserve to be paid?
I picked up all your stockings.
Ah, thank you. Here is your pay.
Your princess wanted a bedtime story, so I gave her a bedtime story.
I wrapped your son and daughter's presents for Christmas.
I made a time machine.
I polished your nails as spick and span, so you could go to bed nice and clean.
We're going on a bear hunt.
We're going on a bear hunt.
We're going to have some big fun.
We're going to have a big fun.
What a beautiful day.
What a beautiful day.
We're not scared.
We're not scared.
Wait, what's that?
What's that?
A river.
A river.
Splash, 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 splash.
Splash, 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 splash.
It's a bear!
It's a bear!
Quick, run! Through the blizzard! Through the forest! Stumble trip, stumble trip, stumble trip, stumble trip! Open the door! Run up the stairs! Over, underneath the bed! We're not going on any more bear hunts again.
I'm under my bed.
You're under your bed. Can you read it? All right. Viviana, you can turn back around.
A helmet?
Good guess.
Brushing your hair? A hat?
Yeah, a hat. Thank you.
There she sits at her little table, doing her puzzle and looking cute and innocent. Looking like she wouldn't melt butter, she's that cool. She can fool some people with that innocent look she can put on and put off when she wants to. But not me. Not even partway. She can't fool me. She don't want to talk to nobody smart. She likes to talk to people she can fool, like her mama and Mrs. Breedlove and Mr. Emery.
Go empty the waste bin. I know you made a bed in the garage behind the old couch, and you sleep where nobody can see you.
I got your number, miss. I've been hearing things about you that ain't nice. I've been hearing you beat up that poor little Claude in the woods. I heard you run him off the wharf. He was so scared.
If you tell lies like that, you won't go to heaven when you die.
I know what you done to that boy when you got him out on the wharf.
And what did I do if you know so much?
You picked up a stick and you hit him with it. You hit him because he wouldn't give you that medal like you told him to. I thought I'd seen some mean little girls in my time, but you're the meanest. You want to know how mean you are? Because I'm mean. I'm smart and I'm mean. And you're smart and you're mean. And I never get caught and you never get caught.
Nobody believes a thing you say.
You want to know what you did after you hit that boy? You jerked the metal off his shirt, then you rolled that sweet little boy off the wharf among them pilings.
You don't know anything. None of what you said is true.
You took that bloody stick and washed it off good. And then you threw it in the woods where nobody could see it.
I think you're a very silly man.
It was you was silly because you thought you could wash off blood and you can't.
Why can't you wash off blood?
Because you can't, and the police know it. You can wash and wash, but there's always some left. Everybody knows that. I'm gonna call the police and tell them to start looking for that stick in the woods. They got what they call stick bloodhounds to help them look. And those stick bloodhounds can find any stick there is that's got blood on it. And when they bring in that stick you wash so clean, the police will sprinkle that special blood powder on it. And that little boy's blood will show up on the stick. It'll show up a pretty blue color, like a robin's egg.
What'd you say about me? It's all about you. You're scared about the police yourself. They'll get you with that powder.
What were you saying to Rhoda?
Well, Mr. Pedmark, we was just talking.
Just the same, you're not to speak to her again. If you do, I'll report you. Is that entirely clear?
Yes, sir.
Daddy, is it true that when blood has been washed off anything, a policeman can still find it? If he puts powder on the place, will the place really turn blue?
Who's been talking to you about such things? Leroy?
No, Daddy, it wasn't he.
Bienvenidos, damas y caballeros. Es un gran placer tenerlos todos aquí, hoy en este día de tanta promesa, porque nuestra comunidad está en un momento donde necesitamos decidir en qué mundo queremos vivir, en qué mundo merecemos. Hoy estoy aquí, enfrente de todos ustedes, para decirle que el futuro es el futuro...
What are you doing?
I'm gonna do the Spanish version.
What? No. No, 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 no.
Look, I know what you're gonna say.
This is suicide.
And I do respect your opinion, my friend, but this is the right move. We have to be able to reach everyone, contact with every single person possible out there.
Yeah, okay. But at what cost? Like, Do you really want your audience to look at you and be like, oh, what the hell is he saying?
Mind the language.
Same to you. English only, my friend. You hear me?
Look, I'm not sure I agree.
Okay. Look, I get it. It's very kind of you that you want to be inclusive. You just cannot be seen as
a Mexican.
Exactly. Do not. Do I need to remind you that you're running for public office? You're an American now, okay?
Mexican. American.
No, American. When they see you, their next congressman, they need to see.
Oh, I know. I understand. This is exactly why we hired you, my friend. They need to see my integrity, my strength, my resolve. They need to see
themselves. They need to see themselves. And I'm sorry, but that's not going to happen with all your, let's see, andale, Bria.
Was that your Speedy Gonzalez?
Who?
All right. You know, I would actually be offended right now if you were an also Latino.
I'm not. And neither are you. Not anymore.
Look, I get what you're saying. I do, but I don't want to deny who I am just to win, all right? It's just...
Oh, you haven't run for public office, have you? Just trust me, will you? I know what I'm doing. You don't want to go down this path.
All right, look. Do you know why I'm doing this? Running? Look, I'm not just some slick city boy looking to satisfy his own ego into politics for himself. No. This is more than that.
Ugh.
So, Sebastian, look at me. I am an immigrant from a pueblo outside of Oaxaca, Mexico. We came here, right? My father did what he had to do for his family. Worked himself on this farmland for 25 years, right? Worked himself to the bone, right? So I can amount to something better than that.
Yes, I know, Andy. I've read your brochure. In fact, I'm the one that edited the final copy. I know all about the Sessler story and how your father was a migrant worker who picked tomatoes his whole life so that his sons can go to college and the American dream, blah, 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 all that. Yes, I know.
That wasn't the American dream. My father hated this country, hated the man he worked for. In this town, of all these people who called him all sorts of terrible things, he had no illusion that this country would treat him any differently than how it actually did. He knew the land he stood on. But you know what was the American dream? When I bought his farmland after law school and showed him the deed and said, this is what you get. After all these years, the final laugh. I'm doing this for him and all the countless lives just like him who sacrificed, withstood, and surrendered their own dignity so you and I can have the American dream.
You know what? That's lovely. Very rousing. But all I'm saying is you don't want to alienate your audience.
And you think giving this speech in Spanish will do that?
I know for a fact it will. Don't remind them that they were once different from them. You are not your father, and this is not... What year did your family come here again?
December of 2019.
Exactly. And what? That was like a decade ago. Listen. I'm going to tell you something that I don't even tell my wife. You're special. You're smart. You're capable and very, very electable. I mean, come on. You have a dead wife. You have two bright and talented kids. You take care of your mother. You live on your father's farm that he toiled away for years. It's gold. And I think with my help, you're going to win this. But the only way knowing is that a lot has changed since 2019. This right here is a different country. We're different. The days of picking tomatoes and jumping over border fences and speaking Spanish, that's all over now. You're white. I'm white. There's no such thing as Latinos or Hispanics anymore. Those terms are dead. Those people are dead. We're just like everyone else. Enjoy it. Take advantage of it. I mean,
What do you think the Irish and the Italians paused when they thought they can join the club? This is the American dream. Comprende? Okay. Now, why don't you practice a speech on me one more time? The right version.
All right. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to have you here today on this day full of promise, because our community is in a moment where we need to decide what world we want to live in, what world we all deserve. Today, I stand in front of all of you to tell you that the future is ours. There is no going back now. We've made it this far, and what lies ahead is for all of us.
Depression is always a serious topic, but even more so now during these times of a global pandemic. Depression is a widely common mental health disorder. It can affect you in ways that prevent you from living a productive and rewarding life. There are several ways that depression can be caused, and oftentimes depression can lead to other mental health disorders and be life-threatening. That is why it is crucial to bring awareness to this topic and normalize talking about it.
Many people confuse depression as weakness. They are wrong. Depression is a real mental health problem with real symptoms. Depression can be caused by social, physiological, and biological factors. It can even lead to other mental health disorders, a common one being anxiety. Depression affects people globally, no matter age, race, or gender. Approximately 322 million people suffer from depression. Depression is 5.1% more common among females than males at 3.6%. Depression commonly leads to suicide. It is estimated that 60% of suicides are from depression. Symptoms of depression include loss of interest and enjoyment, anxiety symptoms, disturbed sleep and appetite, mood and feeling changes, and low concentration. Some symptoms cannot even be explained by a medical diagnosis. Many people fail to get help in fear of this social stigma, but remember, you are never alone in this journey. Many people walk in the same shoes.
Depression is not something to go through alone. The first step is to acknowledge that you need help. If you are suffering from any of these symptoms, please do not hesitate to reach out and talk to friends, family, counselors, or even the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at the number on the screen. Seek help. Depression is more than its stereotype. Break the stigma.
Hi, my name is Christina, and COVID is dominating our lives, and it's essential to wash your hands in order to limit the spread of the virus. But proper hand washing is key. Let me show you. Keeping hands clean helps prevent the virus from spreading.
First step is you want to wet your hands with clean running water, turn off water, and then apply soap.
Second step would be rub your hands together with the soap. Also, you want to get the back of your hands too, between your fingers and under your nails. Third step, you want to scrub your hands for at least 20 seconds, or you can hum the happy birthday song. fourth step, you want to rinse off your hands while under clean water. Last step, you want to get a paper towel or a clean dry towel, or you can air dry your hands. And just dry your hands.